then question number two for final. Normally kita ada energy and also the momentum. And then question number three normally is the mass. Okay, so final assessment, we have only three questions. Okay, let's take a look at this tutorial. So a heated sphere of the radius R is placed in a large amount of stagnant fluid. So consider the heat conduction in a fluid surrounding in the sphere in the absence of convection. So the question is, derive the temperature profile equation by using the shell balance due to the heat conduction in the fluid surrounding the sphere. Given that the R and R is equal to capital R, the temperature is dR. And if R is equal to infinity, the temperature is T infinity. Okay. So when you read the question, first of all, you need to know that, okay, this question asks you to develop the temperature profile. Which method? Using shell balance method. So make sure you use the shell balance method, not the equations of change. Okay. So that is the first thing. And then now we analyze the question. So we have a heated sphere of radius R. So for example, this is the diagram. So kita ada heated sphere. Okay, so it is placed in a large amount of stagnant. So surrounding it is a stagnant fluid. Okay, so the radius is R. And then so kita nak guna apa? Shell balance. So kita ambillah shell balance around the sphere. Shell maksudnya thin layer lah, slab kan. So the shell. So the question is we need to derive the temperature profile. So kita nak tengok how the temperature is distributed to the surrounding. Okay, so boundary condition, we know at the R is equal to capital R, the temperature is dR, means at the surface. So at R is equal to infinity, the T is T infinity. Okay, okay, so start with the shell energy balance equations. So shell energy equation, this is the equation. So normally I more prefer to say that the first three term is as a E, combined energy flux, and then plus rate of work done on system by external force, and then plus rate of energy production equal to zero. So for our system, rate of work done on system by external force, we have or not? External force here, they normally refer to the work shaft atau mechanical work. So in our system, kita ada ke tak ada? Tak ada kan? So it's zero. So what about the rate of energy production? Ada tak energy yang produce? Tak ada. Okay, it become zero. Sebab for energy production, for your syllabus, kita ada dua saja. Sama ada from the electrical or from the viscous dissipation. So kalau viscous dissipation, dia adalah automatic appear. So kita tak perlu tulislah. Kalau SE, then kita tulis. Okay. So the balance yang kita ada adalah E sahaja. So kita tahu previously ada ajar you. So combined energy flux is equal to 1 over 2 rho V squared over rho mu AU V plus Q plus Pi V. Okay. So, tengok sistem kita. Sistem kita, the fluid outside of the sphere is a stagnant. Stagnant fluid means that there is no flow. Okay. So, the V is equal to zero. So, when the V is equal to zero, means that the first term and the third term is equal to zero. So, finally, kita ada E is equal to Q only. Okay, that's why they check up. So, derive your temperature profile by using shell balance due to the heat conduction. And then get the absence of convection because of the stagnant fluid. Okay, then after you dah kenal pasti kat situ, then you can put into the shell energy balance. But you need to remember that the equations of the energy balance is rate of energy. So therefore, the Q here you need to times with the surface area. So surface area for the conduction take place for the sphere here is 4 pi r squared. So this is r means that it in, and then it is out, equal to 0. And you divide by 4 pi r delta r and take the limit delta r as 0. So you get this equation. And this equation actually we can rewrite as the differential equations like this one. Then we integrate. So integrate, finally we get this one. But at this point, supposedly we can solve the C1, but we don't have the information about the boundary condition. So kalau kat sini you nak solve, you mesti ada QR value. But kita tak ada QR value. So yang kita ada apa? Kita ada R is equal to capital R, the temperature is dr. And R is equal to infinity, the temperature is T infinity. So tak boleh lah. Sebab semua berkaitan dengan temperature. Therefore, the Q, we need to substitute by using the Fourier law. Then you integrate, second integration, and finally you get this equation. Okay. And now we try to solve the constant value, C1 and C2. Okay. So here, you need to think which one you need to solve, right? So the first one, if I choose the R is equal to the infinity, the T is T infinity. So that it will T infinity is equal to C1, we divide with the K, R is the infinity times with the C2. Okay, so when you divide something you divide with the infinity, so this value become very very small lah, which is dia akan menghampiri zero, right? You divide pada satu benda yang besar, so the value akan jadi menghampiri zero. Therefore C2 is equal to T infinity. Dan erti kata this one is equal to zero lah. So C2 akan dapat is equal to T infinity. Okay. Contohnya apa? Contohnya 2 you bagi 1 juta. Yang sangat-sangat besar. You bagi 1 juta. So you dapat menghampiri 0.00. So means that lebih kurang 0. Okay. So that you dapat C2 value. So you can put into the replace into the equation, then you use second boundary condition, and R is equal to capital R, T is equal to T naught. So T naught is equal to C1 over K capital R plus T infinity. Therefore, the C1 is equal to T naught minus T infinity times with the KR. Okay, so you have C1, you have C2, then you can substitute into the equation, then this is the final answer. Rearrange to make it more proper, so this is the final answer. Okay, so any question regarding the first one? Boleh? Okay, so now we proceed to question number 2. So question number 2 is from the final exam July 2017, question number 2. Okay, actually this question is very similar to the lecture notes tu hari tu. Cuma the difference is kalau yang hari tu kita punya lecture note kita dia adalah vertical. The wire, the heated wire adalah vertical. But now is a horizontal. Okay, so heat transfer occur when electrical current is supplied through a long rod-shaped copper wire with a radius R and length L. So length L, radius R, as shown in figure The electrical dissipation is given by S is equal to R squared over Ke, where R is a current density in ampere per centimeter square, and Ke is electrical conductivity, which is ohm negative 1 centimeter negative 1. So the wire surface is maintained at that temperature T naught. So wire surface means that at this point lah. So T is equal to T naught. Means that at R is equal to capital R. So assume that the thermal and electrical conductivity are constant. Prove that the radial temperature distribution of heated wire is as the following equation. So you need to prove the equation. Okay. So our system is in a steady state. Okay. That one you could boleh buat sebagai assumption lah. Kalau assumption normally our system, the system is steady state system. And then you can assume the K and Ke are constant value. Okay, so from here, from this one, dia ada sistem apa? Non-flow system ke flow system? Dia non-flow ke flow system? Non-flow system, okay? So the velocity is equal to zero. Okay, okay. So kita ada E, combined energy flux plus work done on system by external force, and then plus heat generate equal to zero. Okay, so heat generate kita ada ke tak ada? Ada ke tak ada? Definitely kita mesti ada lah sebab daripada electrical. Okay, so kita ada SE and dia dah bagi pun. Okay, and then work done by external force ada tak? Tak ada lah. Kita tak ada work shaft kan kat sini. So zero. Okay, what about the E? So E sekarang you kena simplify kan dia. So we tahu E is equal to 1 over 2 rho V squared plus rho U V plus Q plus pi V. Okay, because our system is non-flow system where the velocity is equal to 0. So this term can cancel out. So we dapat Q sahaja. Therefore, dapat Q plus SE dengan 0. Okay, this one in general. But you need to remember that the equation, the energy equation is rate of energy. So, the rate of energy, the Q here, you need to times with the surface area. Meanwhile, the SE, you need to times with the volume. Kenapa volume? Because the SE is a rate of production per unit volume. Okay, so volume can cancel out. Okay, this one I already discussed. Okay, so it times with the surface area. Okay, and this is the volume. Delta R is the thickness lah. Okay, so volume, this is 2 pi R, this is L. So volume, you can timeskan dengan thickness delta R. Okay, so, and then you divide with the 2 pi delta R L and taking limit delta R push to 0, you get this equation. And this equation, you can rewrite in the form of differential equation. And then you integrate, get this one. Okay, this is the equation. Then you label first boundary condition. So at first boundary condition, we know that at R is equal to 0, the Q is finite. Okay, so R is equal to 0. R equal to 0, QR 0 plus C1 over 0. So this is finite at the value. Therefore, this C1 is equal to 0. Okay. Okay. And then you substitute into the equation, then you get this one. Okay. Then you can substitute the QR with the Fourier law. Then you get here. Then you integrate, dapat this ni. So, guna second boundary condition, and R is equal to capital R, T is a T node, this one at the surface. At the surface of wire. So, you masukkanlah T is T node. So, T node is equal to negative SE capital R square over 4K plus C2. So, C2 is equal to T node plus SE R square over 4K. Substitute into the equation. So final, this is the final answer. Okay, so proven. Okay, boleh? Sembarang soalan. Senang kan? Okay. Dah buat ke belum?
Madam, saya nak tanya.
Ah.
Apa beza yang apa yang kita belajar yang horizontal dengan yang vertical tu? Macam
tak ada beza.
Oh, so memang sama.
Sama je. Tak ada beza sebab apa? Dia tak ada efek pun pada sama ada dia horizontal ataupun dia vertical. Sebab kita nak tengok dia punya apa tadi? Temperature distribution. Mana gambar tadi? Okay, so kita hanya tengok dia punya temperature distribution of heated wire ni. So sama je. So cuma nanti you tengok kat sini, dia distribute kalau macam ni. So how dia distribute lah pada wire tu. Kalau kat sini dia macam tu je lah. Sama je. Temperature profile. Okay. Sebab kita punya equation pun dia hanya term dia kalau kita dia adalah combined and then dia ada tak dia pun tu saja. Okay, so R mungkin kalau kan negative K R lah, dia berubah ke ada R. Tak ada perubahan. Tak ada beza. Okay. Okay. Cuma, I just nak stresskan kalau macam katakan in a view of the pembuat soalan. Okay. Contoh kalau macam saya buat soalan kan. Yang boleh saya buat summary. Okay. For this one, kita ada two system. Okay. You mesti ingat. Pertama, non-flow system. The second one is a flow system. So kalau non-flow, means that the velocity is equal to zero. Flow system, V is not equal to zero. Okay. And then bila V is equal to zero, you akan dapati you punya E is equal to Q. Because this one, combined energy is equal to 1 over 2 rho V squared plus rho U. V plus Q plus pi V. Okay. And then either tak kisahlah mana-mana sistem ni. Kalau you kena tahu dia punya general equations is the E plus apa tadi? Work done on system by external force. And then plus heat generate, heat production lah, ataupun heat generate equal to zero. So heat production ni either you punya SE ataupun SV. Okay. So kalau non-flow, I rasa it's very simple lah. Dia akan direct saja. Tapi kalau flow system, dia akan complicated sedikit. Okay. So kat mana kita boleh manipulate? Di sini lah. Okay, so for example, kalau kita kata kita ada E, X, sebab dia boleh ubah dari segi direction dia. Dia boleh ubah, for example, ingat tak kita punya two plate hari tu? Kan? So dia ubah, dia buat kat sini, this is Z, this is X. So saya boleh ubah. Saya kata saya nak buat saya punya ni, this one X, this one Y. So saya boleh juga ubah this one X, this one Y. Depends lah. So bila dia ada perubahan dekat direction, itu memang ambil masa sikit lah untuk kita fikir. So for example, you kena ingat kat sini. So this is, katakan, katakan in term of EX, so you akan dapat even 1 per 2 rho V plus rho U, this is VX plus QX plus pi V X. So kalau EY, dapat 1 over 2 rho V VY plus QY plus pi V Y. Ez 1 over 2 rho v squared plus rho u v z plus q z plus y plus v z. Okay, so depend on the postulate u, sama ada v z sama kosong ke, v y, v x ke. So depends lah yang mana zero, yang mana non-zero, then you need to cancel out. Okay. And this one pun very important. Sebab dia boleh pecah lagi. Okay. So kalau dia pecah lagi, this one actually you boleh tengok dari segi note saya ni, dalam note yang previously ada je. Yang dalam momentum lah. So kalau kita ada pi V X. So macam ni nak pecah ni. So kita ada apa? Pi xx vx, pi xy vx, vy, pi xz vz. So kita ada pi vy, so kita ada pi y x vx, so kita ada pi y y vy, pi y z vz. So kita ada pi v, this is z, so kita ada pi z x v x, kita ada pi z x y vy, z v z. Okay, dan kita simplifikanlah berdasarkan kita punya postulate kita. Yang mana zero, yang mana tak zero. So, you boleh cancel out. Okay, itu je lah. This one, kalau kata, eh, mak, ya Allah tak tahu bila masa pula belajar benda ni, jangan cakap macam tu lah. You boleh tengok dalam momentum. Tapi the moment dalam momentum tu kita bagi yang general punya. Eh, bukan momentum. Ayolah momentum lah. Dalam momentumnya. Okay. Sebarang soalan? Tak ada. Okay, so kalau tak ada, you try buat dululah. Okay, tutorial ni. In fact, I rasa you boleh buat yang kalau you ada another question from the previous punya, pun you boleh buat lah yang the latest. Sebab dia tutorial ni yang lama ni. 2019-2017 yang lama. You boleh tengok yang last pun tanya lah. Tapi the basic is similar. Okay? Boleh kelas?
Boleh.
Okay. Then, you don't forget to fill in the attendance. Okay? Okay. Okay, thank you so much kelas. InsyaAllah jumpa next week eh. In the equations of change. But before that, make sure you dah buat tutorial ni. Sebab nanti bila equations of change nanti, kita akan compare. Sama macam momentum. You dah buat shell, so nanti kita buat equations of change. So that kita kena compare. Okay? Okay, so thank you so much. See you next week, insyaAllah.
Thank you,
Dr. Done for today.
Okay, welcome.